In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of serratus anterior and I will give you tips to palpate where serratus anterior is. This yellow highlighted muscle is serratus anterior. This is part of shoulder girdle muscles. This originates from rib cage, rib 1 through rib 9. And it attaches to anterior surface of scapula. Thus, this muscle moves scapula and that can move rib cage. This is very important muscle for scapula stabilization movement plus rib cage movement. What kind of movement is related to rib cage? That is for breathing. Right? This is my personal experience. When I did the hard upper extremity weight training, then 2 days or 3 days after the training, I had like severe pain around ribcage. Even though when I breathed, I felt pain. I thought my ribcage was broken. I thought I got a fracture. I didn't go to doctor. This is my feeling. This is my subjective feeling. Because of the heavy, hard training, my serratus anterior got too much damage. Thus, I got a pain around here. So that is why serratus anterior is related to ribcage movement. Then, where is this serratus anterior? How can you palpate this serratus anterior? You know, serratus anterior is important for scapular stabilization, upper extremity movement, and core movement, but where exactly is that? Let me explain that. I want to use two muscles to find serratus anterior. First muscle is this one. This is pectoralis major. Let's say pec major. Pec major. And next one is this one. This is latissimus dorsi. These two big muscles are important to find serratus anterior. But how? Let me explain that. This is where your armpit is. This pink part is your axilla, armpit, right? Then in front of axilla, there is pec major, right? This is big muscle. You know where that is. Then posterior from axilla, there is latissimus dorsi. This is also thick muscle. You try to raise up arm like 90 degrees and you know where armpit is, right? Then you go anterior, you can pinch big muscle. This is pec major. And you go posterior, you can also pinch big muscle. This is latissimus dorsi. Then in between these two big muscles, there is flat surface on lateral part of ribcage. That is where serratus anterior is. This is not thick muscle. This is not like a bulky muscle. This is flat muscle. So you almost don't feel there is a meat. There is muscle, but there is muscle. This is very thin, flat muscle. Let me explain that again. This is where your axilla is. And you go anterior, there is pec major. You can pinch that. Then you go posterior, there is latissimus dorsi. These two muscles are very bulky. It's very thick muscle. In between these two thick muscles, there is flat area. There is flat surface. This is where serratus anterior is. Now you know where that is. Then how can you use that? How can you feel using serratus anterior? Alright, one function of serratus anterior is scapular abduction. Scapular abduction. That is not shoulder abduction. This is scapular abduction. This difference is very important. Anyhow, scapular abduction is you bring scapula outward and frontward, okay? Then you try to raise up shoulder like 90 degrees, then bend your elbow like 90 degrees. Try to bring your elbow forward. Then this movement brings scapula outward. This is scapular abduction. Again, you try to bring shoulder upward like 90 degrees and bend your elbow 90 degrees. Then try to bring your elbow forward. This makes scapular abduction. Function of serratus anterior is scapular abduction, you feel contraction. If you don't grasp the sensation of serratus anterior, put your another hand on this flat surface on rib cage. You know, put hand like this, then do same thing. Bring your shoulder up, elbow 90 degrees bend, then try to bring elbow forward. You may feel muscle contraction under your hand. However, again, serratus anterior is not that thick muscle. Thus, you don't feel big contraction like pec major. This contraction is very tiny, very small contraction. So be sensitive. Bring your awareness on tips of your hands, tips of your fingers. Né? Try to do this scapular abduction. Very important thing. And you know, the professional boxer's serratus anterior is developed. You see the contour of serratus anterior on the picture of boxers. Why? Because boxers do a lot of shoulder abduction to throw punches. So you can Google the famous boxer's name. You can Google Floyd Mayweather, Manny Pacquiao, and Gennady Golovkin. These boxers' serratus anterior is developed. You see edge of serratus anterior. That is where serratus anterior is. So look at famous boxer's name. Now you know the visualization. You know the anatomy of serratus anterior. Let's go a little bit different picture. This is pec major. Do you remember? Pec major is one criteria to find serratus anterior. This is where serratus anterior is. You know, this is flat surface. Then this is latissimus dorsi. This is where your armpit is. Go anterior, this is pec major. And go posterior, this is latissimus dorsi. Then this is flat area. You see that? You see this relationship? Now let me talk about importance of scapular stability. When do you use serratus anterior for scapular stability? Oh my gosh, that is for so many things. It's like a push-up, weight training, athletics performance, and there's so many things. Let me pick one example. This person is doing yoga pose. Then this is very hard pose because she is bearing her body weight only on two hands, only on two arms. Her feet are off ground. That is why her feet are not bearing body weight. Thus, stability of scapula is going to be freaking important because scapula is kind of base of upper extremity. Okay, this is kind of solid base of upper extremity. Serratus anterior attaches to ribcage and scapula, right? Thus, this muscle needs to stabilize scapula position. If scapula is not stabilized, then shoulder is not stabilized. If shoulder is not stabilized, elbow is not stabilized, then wrist joint is not stabilized. Serratus anterior is one of the most important scapular stabilizers around upper extremity. So do the same thing, what I just said. Bring your shoulder up, bend elbow bend, then try to bring elbow forward. Serratus anterior works in this kind of movement. How can you train serratus anterior? The basic thing is push-up. You may do push-up, then try to bring your scapula forward. Your serratus anterior is activated. Again, this muscle is freaking important for scapular stabilization. I'm using yoga pose for this example, but this is also important for throwing movement and racket sports like tennis, volleyball, baseball, maybe for table tennis. That is so important for sports that requires upper extremity movement. In today's video, I explained basic anatomy of serratus anterior and where that is. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.